Welcome. We're glad to have you with us this day. And let's welcome. Do we have any others? If not, remember, if you see a fresh face that you do not know, go and introduce yourselves during the passing of the peace. At this time, do we have children that would like to come forward?
Saved and get signed up for that. There is planning a new Sunday school class for the youth and their parents after the confirmation class last year. They felt like there was a need for that, so they're going to try to do that. The class will be on October 2nd. So if you're interested in that, get in contact with Linda Robbins. And of course, the trustees are still asking for some help on getting the debt on the new van taken care of. And you can write van debt elimination on your contribution. Does anyone else have any?
We will be getting an update on where we stand on the van debt. Hopefully we will have that next week. Also, this past week, we did have a meeting for the visions and goals with Steve Parsons. It was a wonderful meeting. Many people came out and discussed. A lot of direction came out of this meeting for the church. We will be meeting again in September, and everybody is welcome to this. The more people we have that comes to this meeting, the more ideas and the better we will have at actually accomplishing the goals. We want to keep the energy level up and keep moving forward. So please keep your ears open for this upcoming meeting in September.
Okay, does anyone else have any announcements? If not, stand up as next.
The Lord works vindication. Thank you.
concerns. Big joy. Bob Haskins is back with us this morning. Anyone else?
The missions team is going to be working at the Chanute Elementary School Thursday and Friday. That's where the haircuts for kids is going to be taking place. So keep that event in your prayers. And thank you for all your donations so that we can give each child a gift bag of shampoo and conditioner and a hairbrush and whatever else they need. So God bless you all.
Okay, anyone else? I'll get there in just a second. Anyone else? I want to thank everyone for all the prayers. I also would like folks to pray for all the wonderful people who work in the skilled nursing facility. I was speaking with an RN this morning, and she works every weekend, 16 hours on Saturday and 16 hours on Sunday. And I know they like to go to church, many of them. And, they're doing God's work, so keep them in your prayers. Thank you. All right, anyone else?
Be sure to keep the folks in the prayer list in the back of the bulletin in your prayers. Anybody else?
If not, then let's go to the Lord in a moment of silent prayer. God, as we come together and we lift up our joys and our concerns, what a joy it is to have one of our Body of Christ members back amongst us this morning. We give you thanks for the restoration of health and the way that you continue to work each and every day in our lives. We also give you thanks for those many volunteers that help different ministries be accomplished through the life of this church. We lift up those volunteers and all those ministries, and we pray, oh my God, that so many lives might be touched. As we come this morning, we do lift up those many others who are struggling with different health concerns. We also come this morning and we acknowledge that on this holy Sabbath, that there are those who continue to work and must work to help their families. We lift them up to you and we pray, oh my God, that they might find a time during the week to be refreshed through your Spirit. All these things, my God, we come and we lift before you as now we lift up that prayer that your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And now with the joy of giving in our hearts, let us offer our tithes and our offerings.
Thank you.
and glory into her name. Amen.
Would you please be seated? As you do so, turn into your Bibles. Hebrews chapter 12, 18 through 29. Hebrews 12, 18 through 29. You have not come to something that can be touched, a blazing fire and darkness and gloom and a tempest, and the sound of the trumpet, and a voice whose words made the hearers beg that not another word be spoken to them, for they could not endure the order that was given. If even an animal touches the mountains, it shall be stoned to death. Indeed, so terrifying was the sight that Moses said, I tremble with fear. But you have come to Mount Zion, and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to innumerable angels in festal gathering, and to the assembly of the firstborn who are enrolled in heaven, and to God, the judge of all, and to the spirits, the righteous made perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that speaks a better word than the blood of Abel. See that you do not refuse the one who is speaking. For if they did not escape when they refused the one who warned them on earth, how much less will we escape if we reject the one who warns from heaven? At that time, his voice shook the earth, but now he has promised, yet once more I will shake not only the earth, but also the heaven. This phrase, yet once more, indicates the removal of what is shaken, that is, created things, so that what cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us give thanks by which we offer to God an acceptable worship with reverence and awe. For indeed, our God is a consuming fire. This is the word of God. Our next hymn is 2017 in the Faith These Day Books. Oh, I'm sorry, 2016. Glorify my name.
Immediately, she stood up straight
and began praising God. The leader of the synagogue, indignant because Jesus had cured on the Sabbath, kept saying to the crowd, "There are 6 days in which work ought to be done. Come on those days and be cured, and not on the Sabbath day." But the Lord answered him and said, "You hypocrites! Does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his donkey from the manger and lead it away to give water? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 long years, be set free from this bondage on the Sabbath day?" When he said this, all his opponents were put to shame. And the entire crowd was rejoicing at all the wonderful things that he was doing. This is the word of God. Please be seated.
Let us pray. Oh my God, as your Spirit fills this space, we just pray that you will open the mouth and open our ears. May the words that I say be those that we are to hear this day. Amen. I really love the scripture that we have before us today, so I want you to hear these couple verses once again from Luke chapter 13, verses 10 and 11. Now he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath. And just then there appeared a woman with a spirit that had crippled her for 18 years. She was bent over and was quite unable to stand up straight. Luke starts off with Christ teaching in the synagogue. Then he presents us with a picture of this bent over woman. Many of you have seen this condition. Most likely, this condition consisted of this woman's spine being so connected that she was unable to stand up straight, and it was quite painful. And she suffered with this for 18 years. Now, notice something else. In verse 11, Luke attributes this condition to a spirit. Now, I want to be very careful and point out that this is not demonic possession of any means. Rather, this is like the torment that Job endured when Satan afflicted his body. The spirit had overtaken her. Now I want us to look at verses 12 and 13. I love this. The woman, she had accepted her condition. She even called out to Christ. It wasn't her that called out to Christ. No, it was Christ that called out to her. She never once said, "Lord, have mercy on me." No. Jesus noticed her. Jesus called out to her, and Jesus freed her from her bondage. From freeing this woman from the evil spirit, Jesus demonstrated his authority over the spiritual realm. In other gospels, especially in the Gospel of Matthew, it talks of the stronghold that Satan has, and that Satan is strong. Well, this shows that Jesus is stronger. He completely destroyed that spirit, that stronghold that was over this woman. And she was set free. Now, the part that I really like about the scripture before us today is how Jesus puts in place this leader in the synagogue. He had the gall to get on Jesus. Well, actually, I want to point out, he didn't actually get on Jesus. He pointed it out to the crowd. He was trying to steer the crowd away from Jesus by pointing out, "This man, did you just see what he's doing? He has 6 days. 6 days to cure people. And he has the audacity, he has the gall to heal on the Sabbath. How dare he? Now, if I stood before you today and if I said, you shall go forth from here and spread the word, help people, help clothe those who need clothes, feed those who are hungry, but only do it on the six days, because on the Sabbath, the only thing you're allowed to do is come here and do nothing else. Would you like that? Would I still be preaching in this pulpit? Probably not. Jesus was trying then, and he turned around and said, you hypocrite, how dare you? You are trying to make people live in the law of the day. He was sent to free them. Christ is trying to set them straight. I love Luke. I love reading through the whole Gospel of Luke, because Luke tends to make a point over and over again when he shows Jesus healing on the Sabbath. Jesus set us free from the law, because the only law that there is through Jesus Christ, our Lord. He is the one that we are to be following. And more than anything, the Sabbath is the days we should be going out and healing people. We should be going out and clothing people and feeding them. It is the Sabbath where we should be most doing these things. We should be doing them each and every day. But it is the Sabbath that we are supposed to be really living in the work of God. And Jesus has shown us. The last point that I want to point out to you all is to go back a little bit. I mentioned earlier that this woman, she did not cry out to Jesus. She did not say, Lord, help me. It was Jesus that went into her. How many times do we see people that are so bound in their pain, in their suffering, that they have lost hope? They believe that there's nothing that they can do, nowhere they can turn to, and they accepted their bondage. Well, in Matthew chapter 11, verses 28 through 30, Jesus says, come to me, all that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Give it to God. Christ offers us so much hope. The woman in the story is freed from her physical affliction. But every day, many of us here are living with the painful fact that life is difficult. Where's our victory? Must we live the rest of our lives with the burden that are around us? Burdens of alcoholism, burdens of drug addictions, burdens of not having enough means to care for our families or ourselves, burdens of being an outcast. What are we to do with all of this? Where is our freedom? In one sense, we all know and understand, or we should know and understand, as I pointed out last week, that our freedom will be attained in the new heavens and the new earth. Christ, through his death and resurrection and enthronement at the right hand of God the Father, lifts these burdens. We understand that. But sadly, there are so many people that lets their burdens define them. That is sad. Their lives become centered around their burdens. And I'm sure that many of you young people like this. If not, you struggle with this yourselves. There's a very famous person, and many of you might know the name, Ted Turner. He let his burdens define him. Him and his father never were close. He could never live up to what his father wanted him to be. Ted Turner went on, and he is the buzz of the media empire. He built the media empire. He became one of the richest men in the world. A prominent business magazine voted him the most successful of the year 2 years ago. And then Ted Turner, while giving his speech to a group of entrepreneurs, he pointed out the magazine, his media empire that he had built. And he asked, "Is this enough, Dad? Is this enough? I guess it will never be enough." Sadly, he is letting his burdens define and run his life. He doesn't understand that our burdens, the things around us, is not what makes us who we are. Jesus is crying out, it does not have to be that way. In Christ, we all have a new identity. We're not just some poor player in this life struggling to get through. We are all children of God. I want to point out that in today's scripture lesson, this woman that struggled with this for 18 years, Jesus called her for who she is. She is a daughter of Abraham. She has an identity. And that's like saying today, she is part of the body of Christ. Be free. You have an identity. Our burdens do not define the limits of who we are. We all have an identity through Jesus Christ. Christ destroyed the law of the day, and instead, he has freed us to live within the new law, the law of Jesus Christ. So I want you, all of you, to go forth from here. Look at what is binding you. What is truly keeping you from living in freedom? What is bringing you sorrow, frustration? I want all of you to look deep in your lives and hand it over to God, because God is calling to you. Be free. Stand up and live in His power, because He is the only power there is. Satan has been defeated. He has bound Satan, and he wants to bind everything that is keeping you from living, truly living. Let us pray. Almighty and gracious God, we do realize that in this world there are so many burdens that afflict us each and every day. Help us to cry out to you. Help us not to accept those burdens, but to stand up and say we want freedom and we want to live in you. In Christ's name, amen.
All right. closing hymn, and it's the Know We Are Christians by Our Love. It's number 2223 in the faithfully St. Louis. If you please stand with me.
Release you from your burdens. Go forth and serve Christ. Amen.